to survive. Now, when I look in your heart, I feel paralyzed. All right, let's get this show started.
Hello.
All right, what's up, gang? My name is Brendan. This is Accidental Origin, your weekly writing web show. I'm streaming at a weird time. I was talking about this a few episodes ago, but yeah, due to some recent scheduling stuff, I'm kind of going with this earlier time slot. I think I'm better, like more energetic and in the right ways at this time than I am later. And I think it works with my schedule a little bit better. So tentatively, this is going to be a permanent change. So yeah. Other than that, how's everyone's week been? What have you been up to? I haven't been doing much, mostly working. I've been thinking about the game a lot. There it is. I've been thinking about the game a lot. How I want to build it, how I want to structure it, what design decisions do I want to make. Things like that. So there's some good stuff going on. You'll see behind me there, because I cleaned my room the other day, or my office. I pulled out my Fighting Fantasy books. I own more than I thought I did. but yeah, so there's a whole stack of them there. Big fan of Starship Traveler. It's like one of the oldest ones I've owned. And then Appointment with Fear, this guy. This is one of the ones I loved as a kid as well. But yeah, so I pulled out some stuff. I forgot I had these too. Dungeons and Dragons Choose Your Own Adventures, like officially licensed by TSR. These are pretty neat. And I have one of the reprints, just one. But so there's that. And I have, again, another TSR one, Marvel Superhero stuff. Choose Your Own Adventure, Marvel Superheroes. These are pretty cool as well. But yeah. Neat stuff. So there's that. And with that in line, we're going to continue working on the game. The interactive fiction thing that we worked on last week. I decided today that, this idea has kind of been a driving force for me all week, where I want to be working on it, and that's awesome. So I'm going to do that. Next week, however, I'm going to finish editing the Fear the Siren, so that we can move forward with that as well. So that's my plan. Finish off July with a cool game, and then in August, start back up, get the story done, move forward with that. So yeah, that's my plan. Let's flip to the main screen here. This as well. So let's do some weirdness with this. Okay. Hope this works. Let's go studio mode. Oh, you can't see anything. I moved my Gorillapod for my VR. And it's really... I need to get another one. Because it, I need something for the second cam to work properly. Can't see it. But I guess I can just hold it. Let's transition here. So yeah, I've been working on kind of the logic of the game this morning. I drew this up right before the stream. And so the text that I did last time, I've kept. I've made some design decisions. And we're going to move forward with that from a new file. Just smooth it out, make our choices, organize it properly. But I want to be finished all of this text by the end of my weekend, which isn't today. I work a little bit differently because of my work schedule. So that's all good. I have a couple more days, but we're gonna finish the text this weekend for sure. All right, main screen. I fixed the scaling. It should actually be mostly readable now. I hope. Ooh. Interesting. I didn't think about how that would be blocked. Oh well, it's not super important. It's just adding include files. So we're gonna go chapter 0. slash branch A. Include chapter 0 slash branch B. C. Say properly, yes, cool. Add characters slash Michael. Characters slash Sam. Cool. We're going to select that. The beginning. This will be an end. I hate underscores in code. I hate that naming scheme. It annoys me so much. I much prefer camel case. I do not like it. So branch A is going to be this. We're going to rewrite it. This in a comment block, so we know. All right, cool. Branch B is going to be this. Again, put it in a comment block. C is going to be comment block. Function here as well. D is gonna have this stuff. Get that. I got that. 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 Take this. This is from Kelly. That I don't actually need that space there. I can do it like this, which is way cooler. Okay, I solved that problem. Sorry, just going over my notes here. Like comments I put inside the text. Okay, I think we're good. Cool. Hey Chris, what's going on? Hey Johnny, what's going on? I was looking for there. Too obvious. I've been struggling a lot with how I want to present this scene. Like, how do I want to introduce you as a character? Like, how do I want to introduce the world of you as a guardsman? Are there, how big is the city you're in? Take a sheet here. Make some notes. How big is the city? How many guardsmen? I mean, part of the reason why I wanted, like, I brought these up, is because I wanted to look at how they started the story. Like, what, how do they present it? And I'm realizing, as I flip these open, there's a background section. I don't know if you can see it there. There's a background section that sort of gives you this backstory of your character, what you're doing. And that's cool. I like that. But at the same time, when you're playing a game, when you're playing a game like this, like the one that I'm working on, that doesn't work as well. You want the players to be there from the get-go. Me and Sam were talking this week about narration, about narrators, and what narrators, the purpose narrators serve in storytelling. In a lot of ways, giving you backstory like that is giving you that narration. I don't know how much I buy it. I don't know if I mentioned this last week, but the plan is for this to be a VR game. I know. You're like, what? What do you mean, Brendan? Why would you make a text adventure VR game? Well, the answer is because I can. And B, because I want to experiment with what VR can do outside of the sort of things other people are doing. So there's certainly that. The other thing is in a VR environment like that, immersion is key. And I think giving you that narration, that backstory, like right up front, kind of kills the immersion in a lot of ways. Let's add a thing here. To do. Save states. Otherwise, we're gonna go the beginning. Get some sleep. I think that should be a question mark. Hello. Considering how decisions are presented, yeah, this literally asks, will you tell him attack? This is one of the early ones. I have a later one, right? I wonder if it changed. wonder if it changed. Yeah, it changed a bit.
But it's not as much as I would have thought.
Okay, cool. I don't need this anymore. Here. It'll be a separate function, a separate not. I think I have my documentation here open on the other window. You can mark subsections, and I'm wondering, yeah, you can do it like that, that's not a problem. So yeah, I can do that. Let's say what should I name this? Hmm. I'm gonna say Get Quest. I'm gonna call this Get Quest because it's hilarious. And when I go to branch C, it's down here, so that's out of the way. We're gonna go. Yeah, Johnny. This is pretty non-traditional as far as storytelling goes. I mean, this is a scripting language. So, it's designed to be a writing tool specifically. So it does very well with just general text and stuff like that. Like, you know, every time I hit a line break, it starts a new paragraph and stuff like that. But yeah, it's pretty non-traditional, all that programming. It is what it is. It's all good. This needs to happen. I do think there should be a to-do here. To put duns at the end of the stitches, or are they just fine? Oh, they're just fine. I don't have to do anything. Okay, cool. Thank you. city name. There's city name. So I'm going to add a variable there. I'm going to clear that in my main file. So after the includes, we're going to put a variables section here. We're going to say var city name equals to be determined. I thought if you called it, it would just go automatically to the first divert. Let's format this a little bit so it's easier to read. This, so maybe that'll clear up an issue. Weird. Let me check their other thing real quick here. Yeah, you need some sort of divert. Which is fine. So we're gonna put one here. Interesting. It's been a long time since I programmed it all, so I'm kind of relearning a lot as we go. At least it's a scripting language and not something a lot more complicated. That would make things a lot harder for sure. Chase thief. Shoot. Pen's not working. options. First section. Determine character. Another big question. Are there non-humans in this world? Thank you.
close it, and I'm gonna reopen it.
I think I'm wrong. I think that this doesn't work. Yeah, I'm right. It doesn't work like that. Interesting. Alright, well, it's 12:55, so I'm going to take a 5-minute break. I think it's starting to come together. It's starting to make sense to me in terms of building this structure. Investigation equals 0.
we should call it ver deduction.
Right, I was taking a break. I had a thought. So yeah, I'll see you all in about 5 minutes. Cool. All right.
I'm back. Right, that makes sense. Coming together for sure. I don't want to make the prototype too complicated, and obviously I can leave a bunch of to-dos and notes in places for things that I would like to do in a bigger project using this as a basis, but I do want the prototype to be fairly straightforward and not get too crazy. Because then in the prototype, you have to build all those crazy things. And that kind of defeats the purpose of a prototype. I mean, you're kind of looking at this as a proof of concept. It will work. You think it will work.
Interesting. All right.
Motion Comics. That's what it's.
Interesting. So I do it like this.
Yeah, so we're going to put an if statement here.
Take this out. Thank you. do. So we don't need any more. So this is going to be shotgun. Excellent. So I go back. Oh. Do I have to stay as Bear Hero Glass? doesn't work. But how do I set variables? How do I change variables? Is that a thing? Am I missing something? Stitches. Huh. Interesting. Conditional text. Different things. I know what I did. I think I have to do it like that, right? Nope, that's not what I wanted. So that's printing variables. That's fine.
Oh, okay. I found it. Found the thing I'm looking for. There we go. That's branch A done, pretty much. At least for the moment, I think that's all that I'm going to. Put this as a big to do under here. Add details. This, to be honest, so I'm not going to bother with it. Cool. So that's that stuff done. Excellent. Hello. Yeah, the thing I'm using right now, though, is called Ink. It's by Inkle. I have the thing open here, actually. It's a really cool scripting language used to make interactive fiction. It's something they designed to do the adaptation work they've done for 80 Days and Sorcery, which are really, really awesome mobile games. You should totally check them out. Interesting. Anyway, doing a thing.
So we're going to put a choice here. Oh, I can pass a temp variable, can't I? Ah, yeah, cool. I can. Good luck with that, Johnny. If someone can do that, I will be their bestest friend, because they will be super powerful and ridiculous. So if I do this. Here.
That should work.
They tell me it should work. Oh, I see what I did. Think about that.
Whatever, it's good enough. So that's branch B done. Branch B done. So branch C. This is where it gets a little complicated. Okay, okay. So just thinking of logic here. End. Okay. So I kind of figured it out. So so I can see it. I'll go to the big one here. So for those who are curious, this is what I've been working off of and what I kind of designed this morning based on the stuff I've been working on. So there's the start, and you have branch A, branch B, which I've been working on, and branch C. Branch C is three locations, or two locations and a character. So there's a small amount of things that happen here, but it's basically an enclosed loop at a single location until you get these two tasks accomplished. Right there. It's hard. This is really hard to do. And then you have branch D, which is a short exploration of the cave with two doors. And then you have the end. Because this is a prototype, and I want it to be short. So, yeah. That's what I've got. But yeah, like this needs to be all rewritten. Okay, I see what I can do here. So I should put this, mark this as first time. Hey, McKelly, what's up, man? Oh, yeah. Thanks for doing that, Johnny. Too lazy to even self-promote myself. Also, I think Bobobot's down again. Is what it is. Yeah, he's offline again. Is what it is. Bobo hasn't posted in 4 days. Yeah, so what we're going to do is we're going to mark the first thing here as static static cave, and then we're going to first time. Good job, McKelly. I realize now that I was doing this before and I actually really prefer it, so I'm gonna fix that real quick. Cause I prefer it. Chase the thief. There we go. I'm gonna say pull out your crossbow here and not do the full description because I think it's better. Here, go outside, take a nap. Yeah, I'm gonna be going about another hour. Oh, right. Sorry, I forgot. I forgot I was showing off the things. This is how Derek must feel every day. Anyway. Cool.
Okay, yeah, I got it.
So the way I'm thinking about this is that I think I should have a flag for the farmer being there. That is set to true when he's there and false when he's not. And it'll give you options when he is there and no options when he's not. If that makes sense. I think that makes sense.
Just a question of how I want to structure that.
So I think what we're going to do is we're going to go prologue events. Maybe. We'll say prologue McKelly. That's what I said. Yeah. Johnny is being awesome, doing that internship, and should go well. Should go well. Stop it. Oh, okay. Removed. Boom. Fixed. No problem, Mikel. Have fun, man. corner. Farmer affection equals zero.
Cool.
Farmer affection equals farmer affection plus two. I flipped. Well, I saved. Anyway, I have a habit. It's a lot easier to do in writing than it is in drawing, but I totally have a habit of hitting Control S every time I stop typing. Like, I save like every minute, minute and a half. So now, do I add the case statement to I think I got it. How do I want to design the inventory? Do I want to have a real inventory, or do I want to just have flags? I think for this, I think we're just going to have flags. I think if it was bigger, you could do something more with an inventory. But we're going to set... I have player variables here. We're going to set var. Var has torch equals 0. And every time we find a torch, we're just going to add 1 to that value.
Yeah.
First if statement is going to go here. Take another 5 minute break here, and then we're gonna finish up all of the farmer interactions, and we'll see how much time we have left after that. But yeah, another 5 minute break. Give me a chance to collect myself. Where's my OBS? There's my OBS. All right, break.
And we're back. All right. I added a couple of things real quick. I added just renamed the cave so there was something to go to. And I added this text so that it would just stay there and rename this so it should all work. There's an error and I don't know where it is. Is it here? Is it these guys? Is that my problem? I don't think that's my problem. I think those were working either way. So, big thing about programming. You're gonna have to deal with errors like this. A lot. Weird though. I think it's in branch C.
I think it's this thing that's messing it up, but I don't know why. Because there's more than one line within the stitch. Yeah. No kidding. Right, so I want this to be dot first time, and also here dot first time. Yes, save. So I'm going to reopen this again and see if that will help. The software is good, it just it gets a little buggy sometimes. That's in branch B? Really? Select that, control exit, that fixes the issue? No, it doesn't, because it's not in class B. Weird, I don't know why it's telling me it's in class B. Oh, it's not, I was just misinterpreting that. Gotta be something here. Is the issue that I'm calling static cave from after it? Does that make sense? Okay. So that's interesting. That this. Completely break it. It was working before. Well, let's see what we do. as 5. We still have a problem with that error. Where is it? Where the hell could it be? So I don't think it's this. I don't think this is the problem. It's telling me line 10. It's something. Is it these? Are these the problem? Is my problem this then? God. So what's the issue? What's the issue? If I put static cave there, oh, the issue is here, I bet. Is this going to be the issue? I bet you this is the issue. Was working. Think mode. Well, I don't need any of this crap. Oh, you know what? Is it here? It's Of course. Of course that's where it is. The one place I didn't look. We got there.
But if I click here, it gives me the options, right? So why? Weird. Very, very weird. I don't know why it does that. What do you mean drawing? At this time or this project or the way I'm sitting? I think so. But I'm not 100% about that yet. Okay. So yeah, let me do this. It's this. It is. It was totally that. That was the problem. Gotcha. Fixed it. So I want to mark this as a permanent thread, which I believe is a plus sign instead of a thing. What just happened? Did I crash it? I did crash it. It actually says Masters of the SrimSram Universe, but you can't see the Masters, it's too high. Wow. I totally crashed it, oh my god. Task Manager. I broke it. Okay, gotcha. So now search the shack and go back outside. I can still go and search the shack and go back outside. Excellent. Got that done. All right. Thank you.
Okay. Now, where were those if statements? So, if I'm reading this correctly. Okay, I got it. Found my else if. How are you going to boost your inspiration, Johnny? How do you train that? I'm not saying you can't, and I actually think it's a really good idea. I'm just wondering what your approach would be. Well, normally I would do this using the cool tunnel feature I saw, but these aren't really as freestanding as they seem. So I'm going to say go back to cave entrance. Yes, that's what I want.
Hopefully they can store negative numbers. It shouldn't be an issue, but, you know, just in case. Then, what I want to do is I want to put an if statement here. I want to say, if, God, what was my variable? Getting things in scene prologue, right? To do these as the this. I want to do it this. I don't know if that makes sense. Let's go back to the beginning. Oh, Jesus. Is that not a logic or sequence? Confused. Oh, I gotta use equals equals. Gotcha. The Boolean test. Of course. Of course. This will be...
there. Oh, perfect. That's exactly what I wanted to do. So if I go back a step, if I go inside this shack and go back outside, it'll still show me the thing. Yeah! Perfect. Perfect. That was an important thing. Change this ordering because I don't like it. The shack is on your left. The entrance to the cave is on your right. Perfect. Cool. So I got that all working. I just gotta program the cave. We got 10 minutes. So we're going to put another conditional statement here. Don't need that statement. If as torch is greater than 0, then do this. Give them the option of then we put in our else. So if we go inside the cave, perfect. Torch plus 1. Save. So if we go
Shaq. Oh. Back. Start from the beginning. What the hell? I broke it. Yeah. Okay, so that solved most of the problem. Is he now? What questions is he asking? Perfect. I realize I want these to be permanent. Well, I guess this doesn't matter. Oh, I see what I need to do here. What I should do is I should this a stitch here. Yeah, well, I'm actually really, really close to finishing this, so I want to put on the last couple of things really, really quick so I can actually be done and maybe move on to the next sort of step in my plan. So we're going to call this... we'll call it Crossroad. That's what we'll call it. Take the left door. It goes back out. Okay, cool. Perfect. That was what I needed to do. So yeah, what am I missing? Oh, I gotta add interview with that. Just gonna do my to-dos real quick in 2 minutes. Stream. Add the Sam the Skellington interactions. And add to do here. That's an interesting thing. Go back. Oh god, I gotta end the thing. So if I go inside the cave and go back, go inside the cave again. Yeah. Okay. That's what I thought. Cool. Anyway. Put my OBS here. That's it for me today. I've pretty much finished the actual interactions of this. There's just a couple of flavor things, other than the interview with the witness, which I think actually needs to happen. Yeah, mostly just flavor stuff left. So I'm basically where I want to be, where I can move on to doing some Unity coding and play around with this, see what it can do. Work on the prototype. So yeah, I've been really enjoying this sort of scripting language that feels like writing. Like, and that's what's so intriguing about this, and you know, being in creative and being a writer and doing all this stuff is, this is writing. Like, I'm literally writing text, and then. Like, I'm yeah, of course I'm writing text. I'm literally writing a story and then adding little bits in which make it interactable and make it a game and give you choices and branches and interesting things. So, yeah. It's cool. It's very cool. But it's 3 o'clock, so stream for this week is over, unfortunately. My name is Brendan. This is Accidental Origin, your weekly writing rep show. As always, you can check out all the VODs on the URL right over there. Follow me on Twitter if you want to see updates and or let me know what you think. Questions, comments, offers of free food. I don't know. Do what you got to do. But yeah, that's me. This is what I'm working on. Peace out.